Yo, YouTube, what's crackin' like a jack of smack in this Waffle Man for video, and I'm finally gonna be making my next build. I might not upgrade this build for a while, but I just wanna make it just to see what he can do. And as you guys know I'm making a pure sharpshooter because, first of all, my pro marina team, we don't really have any pure sharps. I know we got two cool as a pure stretch four, but a pure sharp is really what you need. I mean, a pure stretch and other sharpshooting builds that have sharpshooting as a secondary primary could shoot the three ball, but not like a pure sharpshooter. And you're gonna see what I mean. You see the badges, of course, Hall of Fame corner specialist, deep range Jedi, limitless range, catch and shoot, free throw race, mid-range Jedi, tire to score, which is great. Difficult shots is silver, which is still good. And for some reason, I didn't even know this, but they got bronze defensive stoppers. So maybe it's fair because I guess lockdown defenders have corner specialists. But after playing this game a while, I think 2K should have never given pure lockdown defenders corner specialists. And just for the pure sharpshooter, they shouldn't be getting defensive stopper. Like, why? But anyways, I'm gonna make my height about 6'5 or 6'6. I'm thinking 6'5 because I usually make my sharpshooters 6'5. He's been 6'5 in 2K17 and 2K18. Now the difference between 6'5 and 6'6, as you're gonna see, mainly is going to be the speed and speed with ball. So if I make him 6'5, obviously you see right now the open shot mid is a 91, open shot three is a 92. You make him 6'6, open shot three is a 91. Open shot mid goes to a 90, so you will see some differences. Speed with ball is a 69 at 6'6. 6'5, your speed with ball is a 70. But speed is also important, so your speed with this one is a 74. Speed with this build right here is a 72. So it's all about preference. Honestly, I'm thinking I might go 6'5 because I'm gonna be at shooting guard anyway, so I don't think I need to be that tall. So I'm gonna be 6'5. Gonna be an interesting build, but we got more categories and you're gonna see the changes with those categories, such as weight and such as wingspan. So for weight, like I did with my playmaking shot creator, I'm gonna go to the lowest weight possible to where it doesn't really affect. Well, actually, I really only need speed with ball with this build, so I could actually increase this build's weight and have the same three-point shot but lose speed with ball. So the only difference is going to be I'm obviously losing speed with ball. Speed is not on here, but you got to be careful because acceleration does matter. And, you know, lateral quickness matters too. So you might not, especially if you're a sharpshooter, you might not want to have this build at max strength, obviously. So I'd probably lower it down a little bit because I really don't need strength that much, box out or contact dunk that much, since my dunks are very minimal anyways. So you really want to lower this probably, maybe even all the way down. I ain't gonna lie, but I usually keep it at 184 because speed with ball usually doesn't go down any further. 72 right here. I'm gonna be looking at acceleration though, because I think I kind of want to have the highest acceleration I can get. And acceleration right now is a 74. If I change it to 175, my acceleration is a 75. So I might go with 175. Of course, I get a little bit extra lateral quickness, I believe, compared to 184. And actually, no, you don't really know. But acceleration, listen, this is going to be my lowest weighted player. And even though I lose strength and contact dunk and box out, I don't really think it's necessary. And he's going to be small, but he has one purpose on the court, and that is to shoot three-pointers, man. If I'm going to be guarding anybody on the court, it's probably going to be a pure sharp in Arena Pro-Am. But you guys already know the gist of that. Moving on to probably the final thing that's important to this build, which is the wingspan. Now, some people might be like, oh, you already have great three-point shot, 93 point shot, you know what I'm saying? 92 open three-point shot, 91 contested three-point shot. And you'd be like, yo, just keep it like that, man, and have a decent wingspan to contest shots. And if you maximize this wingspan, obviously you'll still have an open shot three of an 88, which is cool. Open shot mid takes a bit too much of a hit for me to like this, so I'm probably not gonna do this, obviously. And if you minimize the wingspan, however, you get a 97 open shot three, 98 open shot mid. Obviously contested shot mid is only an 89, and contested shot three is a 90. So Listen, the drawbacks is that your contested shot three, if it's max wingspan, only goes to a 92. So at that point, if your contested shot mid only goes to a 92 compared to having an open shot three of a 97 and having a contested shot three of a 90, obviously I think the minimum wingspan is where it's at. Now some people might be like, oh Waffle Man, you need that, at least your shot contest is going to be bad. Listen, I'm a pure sharpshooter, not going to be a defensive build. But I want that max three-point shot, man. I want that open shot three to be as high as it can go. Not only that, my open shot mid is a 98, and the moving shot mid is a 95. Like, it's higher than any shot creator I have right now. And also, the moving shot three is a 90. So this build might be cheesing, man. Especially if you get your badges. So I'm going to keep it like this. This build is going to be beast, bro. Like, I cannot wait to be shooting on the park, shooting in prom, just to see how the shooting is. Because I've seen people cheese the shooting, man. All of these takeovers, all of these badges, it's just insane. But we're going to take a look at the attributes and see what we get starting off. So if we take a look at these attributes, you're going to see the layups only go to about a 70 driving layup. Two balls for dunk. We're not going to be dunking anywhere. Ball handling, of course, 66 speed with ball passing. All this stuff is not really going to matter as of right now. Steal only goes to 63 blocks. Shot contest is a 46. That shit is trash. Vertical 68. Lateral quickness is only a 72. Speed is a 70. My slowest build so far. Acceleration is bad too. Everything right now other than shooting is pretty much terrible. But the main thing is the mid-range and the three-point. So starting off, the mid-range is 87 open shot mid. 83 moving shot mid, and you see we have quite a few bars to go, so hopefully we get some of these upgrades quicker than my other builds. Open shot three right now is a 90, which is okay, but we do have, like, I believe three more bars left. So like I said, man, hopefully we get, like, as soon as we get the first upgrade, I believe we're gonna get some upgrades to mid-range and three-point. That's what we need, man, because that's where we're gonna do most of our damage. You know, open shot three of a 90 is good starting off, but this build is just about shooting, man. Like, I don't see, other than that, I don't like anything about this build, man. But of course, it's a pure shop, so you know what you're getting into. But anyways, man, leave a like for more. This is a 6'5 minimum wingspan, 175 pound pure sharpshooter. I'm out for now. Peace.